Dan Larson here, and I'm at the photo booth taking a look at this week's flea market finds. We're going to break from form and start in the back. I'm sure you all recognize this thing here. It's the 1993... Oh, see if I can get it off my stand. This is the 1993 Bandai Power Rangers Green Ranger Dagger. I'm going to be honest with you here, I didn't really watch that much of the show. It was written a little too young for me. And actually, you know what, to tell you the truth, I lived in Japan from 1980 to 1983, so I was a Power Ranger fan before they even came to the United States. I was watching Denshi Sentai and Sun Vulcan, and we left on Goguru 5, Goggle 5, one of the less loved ones, probably because of all the ribbon work. But anyway, this is Zoo Ranger, or Green Ranger's dagger. Hey, it works. Sounds terrible, but I think that's just a matter of the age of the item here. But pretty good condition. I was pretty psyched to see this. Actually, my wife, Kate, found this. Somehow I walked right by it. She spotted it on a table, grabbed it, because she knows what's good. On the side here, we also have Power of the Force, 1997. Slave Leia, I'm sure you heard recently that Disney Lucasfilm decided that they're not going to be putting out anything else with the Jabba's Prisoner version of Princess Leia. So I already had this figure. If you've listened to the show, if you've watched the show, you know that I actually do. Well, if you follow me on Instagram, you definitely know. I like the Power of the Force stuff. Some of it, not all of it. There's no line that's 100% fantastic. But as far as the Power of the Force stuff goes, I like it more than most people. And I still think this is a pretty good version of this character. I did not have the regular photo version of her carded yet. I have the freeze frame, and I have the hologram version. So saw this, had to grab it before prices go really insane. Not sure if they're going to go insane, but they might. Over here we have Transformers, Robots in Disguise. This one's a weird one. This is Stormjet. Or is this Jetstorm? This is Stormjet. I don't know why I like this mold. I wasn't really into Transformers at the time. In fact, I just saw this one for the first time this weekend. I already had Jetstorm, who is the exact same mold. Jetstorm, Stormjet. I think that's how it goes. I dug this guy. He's the blue and yellow. I don't know, there's just something about the jet mode that I dug, and especially in the blue and yellow. And as you can see, I cut his the head. I don't know, this is a weird head. You get these weird ear things. And over here on the blue and yellow one, I cut him off because I thought it made him look a little bit more like a pilot. Everybody's got those things where they're just like, I don't really want to explain it, why I like it. I just like it. And, you know, this is one of those things. And he's obviously got the Jetfire coloring, so I had to grab him. And I don't think we need to say anything else about that. In the front, we've got a couple of G.I. Joe figures from back in the day. We've got Hydro Viper. He was missing a few pieces, but he's got his important parts. He's got his little stingray here, scuba pack, his awesome helmet, and his weird flippers. You know, if only some military or paramilitary organization would dress their guys up like this. I don't know. I would find it hard not to support them. I know they're a terrorist organization with bent on ruling the world, but they've got a great costume designer. What are you going to do about that? How are you going to fight those guys? We also got the Toxo Viper. No weapons or anything. And then, of course, the version 3 Alley Viper. He does have his sweet... is it a wolf? Is it a cat? I don't really know what it's supposed to be. But he did have his sweet mask. And, of course, this shield came with him, but does not actually belong to him. He goes to the version 1 Alley Viper. But I'm sure I have an extra... version 1 Alley Viper that needs that shield, so I didn't mind grabbing those guys. And then over here we've got the Greg Capullo. I don't know how this guy was at the flea market. This stuff always surprises me when I see this kind of stuff there. This figure came out, I believe, either end of last year or the beginning of this year. This is the DC Collectibles Greg Capullo version of Mr. Freeze. Unfortunately, he is missing some pieces, his weapon, this armor plate, and the best part about him, his glass dome. But see, I consider myself a future action figure customizer. I don't actually do any customization work right now, but at some point in the future, I think I'm going to be really into it. So for now, I think I'm just sort of stockpiling all kinds of interesting pieces and parts that may or may not find themselves into a customization someday. And that's pretty much why I grabbed these other two guys here. This Deadpool figure, Marvel Select Deadpool, 2010, something like that. But they've kept this guy in circulation. It's a weird thing that Marvel Select does. They keep putting these guys out year after year, which I would guess collectors appreciate, but scalpers don't, because it keeps killing the prices on the stuff. This knife handle always breaks off, and he doesn't have any of his weapons, but still a cool figure. And then, of course, the New 52 version of DC Collectibles, Deathstroke, a character that I never really, Wade Wilson, right? Isn't this Wade Wilson and Slade Wilson, something like that? Never really cared for Deathstroke. I'll be honest, I don't really even know that much about Deathstroke. As far as I'm concerned, he's the guy that has the half-and-half mask, which I always found weird that he's just got the one eye, and I don't know, I mean, this is a cool design for a figure, even if you don't know anything about the character. Missing his guns, missing his knives, all that stuff. But still a cool guy. And then, of course, right in the back, longtime viewers of the show will appreciate that I was able to grab a Marvel Select Venom, finally. If you've been watching, and if not, you should go check it out right now. We did do a review of the Marvel Legends Anti-Venom, earlier on the show. And, of course, he's still in the same position. He's still in the same position that I left him in after doing that review. Because, for me, you find a pose that you like for a character that just seems to suit them, and you just leave him there. And that's how he's been ever since that review. But in that review, I mentioned that there's pretty much no contest between these two figures. If you're looking for an anti-venom, you just can't beat this Marvel Select. The detailing is incredible. The sculpt is amazing. The paint wash into all the stuff. And I'll be honest, this is the most painful action figure I've ever purchased in my entire life. I did not realize these spikes are so spiky. It's like trying to hug a rose with all the thorns. Beautiful, painful, dangerous. Just trying to bend his legs, I practically drew blood. So I can't. That's a weird recommendation to give you for a figure, but if you need an anti-venom, if you just like the look of this guy, pass on that dude. Buy this one. He didn't have his stand as the flea market. What do you want? But I also didn't pay a lot for him. Anyway, thanks for checking out these flea market finds with me. If you stuck with me to this point, please take a second and like this video. If you haven't already, please subscribe. Later.